And we're live.
We're live.
Welcome back to Songs in the House.
Yes, sorry we had to cancel the other night. We had a little bit of a family issue we had to deal with, but we are back.
Yes, we are back. This is our eighth show. This is a little thing we've been doing based on Stars in the House with James Wesley and Seth Rudetsky, which is mini concerts during the quarantine with Broadway stars, and we thought it would be a great idea to do it with some community stars.
Yes, and all while raising funds for White Plains Hospital frontline workers. So any amount that you could donate goes to the doctors, the nurses, the people that are working so hard on the front lines treating COVID-19 patients. So we thank them. And also on every broadcast, we have our very own Bruce Sachs, doctor and musical theater expert, who gives us fun anecdotes and advice.
So let's bring him on.
Yeah, let's bring him on. There he is.
Hey, hey, Bruce.
Hi.
We can't hear you.
Can't hear you.
Now I'm joining the audio.
Yeah, there we go.
There you are.
How's it going?
All right, how are you guys doing?
We're good.
We're good. We're glad, happy to be back.
Back and better. Yeah,
we missed the grand performance last Sunday. Hopefully we'll shoot for next Sunday, right?
Yes, we're planning to move that to this coming Sunday.
Yes, that is the plan.
Very cool.
Yes, so I hear you're a big celebrity right now, huh?
Yeah, well, we have a little clip to share.
Oh,
yeah,
no, don't
share
do that.
Something with our listening audience, because yeah, you're a big star right now.
Oh boy.
Here we go.
All right.
We had our personal heroes, but there was just a lot of stuff. Obviously, we had a fantastic music director named Bruce Sachs there, who is a fantastic pediatrician on the Upper East Side, if you need a great pediatrician. But he was getting himself through med school and music directing shows at camp, and he was a great influence to us, and he was a great arranger. And yeah.
Yes.
Wow. Oh,
there you go. That was like, you know, about 80 years ago.
Yeah, so you want to explain what she was talking about there?
Well, I mean, that was Andrea Burns, a dear friend of mine from, you know, and Jason Robert Brown. And we all went to camp together at French Woods, which was, you know, who doesn't know about French Woods? I think our guest tonight will know a little bit about French Woods. You know, we started out literally when Jason was, I guess when he was like 11 and Andrea was 11 or 12. And, you know, I was a musical director there for many years. So one of the productions that I did the production of Cats with the two of them, which they referred to in, you know, that he played Rum Tum Tugger and you know, Cats was done by French Woods, which I guess I can say now without getting arrested, but it was done illegally. Cats was on Broadway at the time, and, our very bombastic, let's say, director of the camp, Ron Schaefer, basically said, you know, I want to do Cats. We're doing Cats. So we got about five or six people together. I think probably Brian Besterman was involved in this in some way. Our shout out to Brian. But many of us got together and picked off all of the songs from the score of Cats and wrote them down on paper, including arrangements. You know, arrangements for full orchestrations for every song. And I was the piano player, and we played like the whole score of Cats really by just like ripping it off from the album. And so there were a lot of really talented people in that show. Andrea also did Baby, you know, at French Woods. I believe it was 1986. Somebody's going to kill me because I got that wrong, but that was another wonderful show where, you know, Andrea played your role, Lizzie.
Yes, and, yes, I did that way back then too.
Yeah, and that was, you know, some great times back there. But we go back a long way. So that was really nice of her to
absolutely very
shout out a little.
Very impressive. Yes, very fun. So we wanted to share that with our listening audience.
Yes.
Oh boy.
So I guess we should get to our guests for the day. Today we have two siblings that are actually quarantining together, Scott Weinstein and Kayla
Benson.
Yes.
Let's bring him in.
Hi.
Hello. Hello, guys.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you? Yeah, we can sit for a little bit.
Good. So, how have you guys been during the quarantine?
Pretty good. How are you guys doing?
Yeah.
Good. So,
pretty good.
You know, you guys have been quarantining together?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. Very cool. Are you doing it? Doing a lot of singing?
Of course. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's pretty big bummer, right? Though all of the summer plans are have gone to pot, pretty much.
Yeah, they're pretty much all online now.
Yeah. Are you guys doing anything online this summer in terms of summer programs or?
I might. I'm not sure though. I haven't really looked into it yet. But I definitely will look stuff up and see if there's anything I'd like to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the two plans that I had previously was going to go to are now just postponed. To like the online venue. So I'm going to do those instead.
I mean, how do you do a dance class online? Can I ask about that?
Oh, I don't know.
I took a ballet Zoom class last weekend, and it wasn't too bad for a Zoom class. So it was pretty nice.
Okay.
Interesting.
It definitely sounds interesting. I guess it's a good alternative to not doing anything.
Yeah, definitely.
For sure. So, should we get to your first song?
Yes, yeah, sure. We get. Okay.
You're going to reach over.
Tell us what you're going to be singing and.
Okay.
He's going to be singing.
Okay.
Pull up this track.
Oh,
that's a different track. Okay, this is "Let's Start Tomorrow Tonight" from Smash.
Oh, baby.
Round and round goes the wheel of love. Some say like Russian roulette. There's a jackpot I'm dreaming of. I'm ready to place my bets. No need to beg, steal, or borrow. The future is looking bright. Yes, I'm laying odds on tomorrow. So let's start tomorrow tonight. Can't you feel, baby, we're in the chips? Tomorrow's our lucky day, yeah. I can feel gold at our fingertips. We'll prosper if we parlay, yeah. No time for sadness and sorrow. Together we'll fight that fight. Yes, I'm laying odds on tomorrow. So let's start tomorrow tonight. Don't need no clover or lucky charm. That rabbit can keep his foot. As long as we're walking arm in arm. It's aces I feel, so shut up and deal. I know that we're on a winning streak. The future can't come too soon. Let's climb together to reach that peak. Then baby, we'll shoot the moon. I'm high as Kilimanjaro, and with you, Jack, I'm ready for flight. Yes, I'm laying odds on tomorrow, so let's start tomorrow tonight. Yeah. And as long as we're walking arm in arm, it's aces I feel, so shut up and deal. Oh, I know that we're on a winning streak. The future can't come too soon. Let's climb together to reach that peak. Then baby, we'll shoot the moon. I'm high as Kilimanjaro, and with you, Jack, I'm ready for flight, yes. I'm laying odds on tomorrow, so let's start tomorrow tonight. So let's start tomorrow tonight. Yeah.
Woo.
Wow, you killed it.
That was great.
Thank you.
Was Harry Connick in the room for a minute there?
Yeah.
Sounds like Harry Connick at, like, you know, you got that smooth, silky.
Yes. You know, absolutely.
Vibrato.
Yeah, I think, so Ben was reminding me, Leslie Odom sang that in Smash, is that correct?
Oh, I'm not sure.
Ben?
I think so.
I think that's the name I read on the cast recording.
Yeah, I think he had like a small part in the show, in that show.
Mm-hmm.
Before he was anyone.
Yeah, no one really knew him at that point.
Uh-huh.
I mean, and I hear they're doing a Smash reunion, right? What is that all about?
I think they're doing like a reunion concert or something like that.
Oh, really? Where are they doing that?
It must be virtual.
It's virtual, yeah. I have to say that these virtual concerts are plentiful these days.
There's so many of them.
Yeah. All the entertainment you can get.
The one that kind of annoyed me a little bit though was the Mother's Day review that was like all the cast of different Broadway shows.
Yes.
But they were either doing comedy sketches or they were singing songs with lyrics written for coronavirus. You know, I'm sorry, if you have Bernadette Peters and Betsy Wolf on your show, you know, don't give me some parody about coronavirus. I want to hear the real deal, you know. That was like, I didn't even make it through the whole hour, to be honest.
I agree. It was disappointing.
Didn't love that.
And I thought the Tuesday night show, that New York Marathon Telethon, that was a little disappointing too. I don't know if you saw that. It was all those people singing. What did they sing again?
They did like New York, New York.
New York, New York. But it was like Chris Jackson and Karen Olivo and. It was a lot of good people, but that's all they really did. They just sang that one song.
I didn't see that one.
Yeah, it was Tuesday night.
Yeah, it's not worth your time, to be honest.
No, wasn't that great? So on that note,
would you Lucy,
get to your next song?
Yeah.
Do you want to do On the Right Track?
Yes, we can do that one, sure. So this one is On the Right Track from Pippin.
Oh, yeah.
You know that one.
Oh no. They just deleted the video. Yeah, the karaoke video. It just worked 10 minutes ago. Let me pull it up.
I think this is it.
Oh. Technical difficulty.
Okay. You look frenzied. You look frazzled. Pink dazzled. Flushed and rushed and razzle dazzle, dry your lips and your scalp. Now I can see you're in a rut in disarray, and I'm not one to butt in fact. If you take it easy, try it a while, don't look blue, don't look back, you'll pull through in just a while, cause you're on the right track.
On the right track.
Take it easy.
On the right track. Keep those hopes aloft.
Keep cool as custard.
Trying hard.
Stepping soft.
There's no trick to staying sensible. Despite each cul-de-sac, cause each step's indispensable when you're up.
On the right track.
On the right track.
Take it easy.
On the right track. Break.
pulse is low.
But what I've left behind looks trifling. What's ahead looks black. Am I doomed to spend my life a lingering on?
Lingering on.
Lingering on.
No lingering on.
Oh, I'll never find it. Never, 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 never.
Great.
It was really fun.
You guys sound great together.
Thank you.
Dude, you must sing together a lot and harmonize together, huh?
I remember that duet. Who else sang that together? Let me think about that. Could it be our children, Debbie?
Could be. Yes, that sounds very familiar.
It's ironic because Scott is really officially Joelle's duet partner, you know.
Yeah.
Yes. That is true.
I stole her for just that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. Borrowed her. So Kayla, you've been singing a lot. You've been playing the piano, playing your guitar. Yeah. You've played all your instruments.
Yeah, I just started learning ukulele.
Okay.
So that's pretty fun. My dad got me a learning one. So it's been fun. I've been trying to get a lot better at like instruments during quarantine. So.
Yes. Well, it gives you a lot of time to do all that stuff.
It does.
So I also just want to remind everybody to please go to my YouTube channel. And if you scroll across on the top to where it says about, you will find the link to White Plains Hospital. Please, whatever you can give, $1, $5, any amount goes to helping the nurses and the doctors with supplies, medical equipment. It helps feed them when they're working. Really, any amount is really helpful. We really are so grateful to these people and everything that they're doing. So thank you for any kind of donation you can make.
Definitely. So would you like to get to your next song?
Sure. Let me get out of the way.
Yeah.
So Kayla, what are you singing?
I'm singing Pulled from Adam's Family. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled, and I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction, but I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do? Mother always said be kind to strangers, but she does not know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction. But I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. And this feeling I know is impossibly so. I'll fight and I tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Puppy dogs with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies at picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow fights, and Christmas Eve sugar plums. Chicken corsets and chia pets in afternoon banana splits. Angels watching as I sleep and Liberace's greatest hits. Has got me pulled in a new direction. If you keep insisting, I'll stop resisting. I've got me pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark, not obey every spark. But the boy has a bite better than his bark. And you'll bet I'll bite too. Do what's truly taboo. As I'm pulled in a new direction.
Woo. Very good.
That's not easy.
That was not an easy one.
That is not, that's got a lot of range and a lot of words.
It does. I wanted to pick a song that could test my range.
Well, I think
stay in my comfort zone.
Yeah, wow, that was great.
Yeah.
Great to, you know, to challenge yourself. That's awesome.
I think we spoke in rehearsals a few times about not blowing the whole room out. And I think you're really working on kind of reining it in, controlling. You're controlling your, I can see you had much really, really nice control. And you know, you didn't blow your tire out right at the first two lines of the song. You really saved a little.
Yeah.
So that's really great.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Absolutely. For sure. So I think, we have a special guest coming on today.
Surprise guest.
Special surprise guest that has something to share with us.
Spring.
Surprise to me too. Oh my God, who's this?
Hi, Joelle.
Hi. I was having some technical difficulties. I couldn't watch it on YouTube for some reason. I don't know if other people...
No. This is impressive. Even your dad didn't know you were coming on.
I had no idea.
So you have something to share, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, I just wanted to sort of get the word out. So if you don't know what My Sister's Place is, it's an organization that helps people who have survived domestic abuse. And their work is always really, really important. But especially during this time, they're doing a lot of really important work with all the quarantine and the stay-at-home orders. It's really hard for a lot of people who are affected by this. So I reached out to them and asked if there's anything that we can do to help them or if there's anything that they need at this time. And they said that some things that they need are protective gloves, protective masks, disinfectant sprays and wipes, and then $25 gift cards to like MasterCard, Visa, Amazon, Target. And they also said like Dunkin' Donuts and things like that, because sometimes people enjoy having treats and things like that. They're also looking for like DVDs, like exercise videos, like Zumba and other things like that, and books and magazines, puzzles for children and adults. So I'm gonna be bringing stuff to their office at the end of May. And if there's any way that you would feel comfortable and you'd be interested in contributing to that, you can reach out to me and we can work out a way that I can pick it up, no contact, or we can do it virtually. So you can always contact me. My email is joelle.hannah7@gmail.com.
Okay.
Great.
Thank you, Joelle. You're doing good work. Important work for people that are, you know, going through hard times.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. So anybody out there that listening that can, donate some items, that would be really helpful to people.
Even if it's just like a small cash donation, really anything helps. So whatever you can do would be really greatly appreciated. Thank you.
No, that's great.
Great.
Thank you for spreading the word. Thank you for doing the work.
Yeah, no, I'm working all day. I come home, you know, I didn't even see her yet. doesn't even tell me that she's gonna, I should really attend these pre-production meetings that you guys.
You know what, we kind of planned it just not that long ago, an hour ago. So
yeah.
Well, you know our guests. I know you're familiar. We were talking about how you and Scott do a lot of duets together.
Yes, I was able to see like part of the singing. I missed some of it because I don't know, it was saying unavailable, but you guys sounded really great from what I heard.
Thank you.
Yes. So.
And I love Smash, so that was a great choice.
That's a great song.
Yeah, for sure.
Would you like to get to your last song?
Yes.
Sure.
So what is this song, Kayla?
17 from Heathers.
17 from Heathers, okay. All these things I don't know.
Fine.
You know that one, Joelle.
Damaged, but that does not make us wise. We're not special, we're not different. We don't choose who lives. Let's be normal, see bad movies, sneak a beer and watch TV. We'll bake brownies or go bowling. Don't you want a life with me? Can't we be 17? That's all I want to do. If you could let me in, I could be good with you. People hurt us,
or they vanish.
And you're right, it really blows. But we let go.
Take a deep breath.
Then we'll buy some summer clothes. We'll go camping.
Play some poker.
And we'll eat some chili fries. Maybe prom night.
Maybe dancing.
Don't stop looking in my eyes. Let us be 17. Is that so hard to do? If you could let me in, I could be good with you. Let us be 17. If we still got the rights, so what's it gonna be? I wanna be with you.
I wanna be with you.
Wanna be with you till night.
Is that it? Yeah, I think it is. That was great.
Oh, that was great.
That was great.
You weren't sure when it
ended. I don't know the song. I didn't know when it ended. That was great.
It's hard to hear the accompaniment, so it's hard to hear when,
yes,
when it went off, but you've just been Zoom bombed by Ben.
I very much apologize. That's live theater, I guess.
It's really, you're right, it's hard to hear. I was like, wait, I think it's over.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really quiet right there.
It was really quiet.
But that was great.
That was really good.
Thank you.
Yeah. Your harmony sounds great.
Thank you.
Really, really great. Wow. Awesome. It's a fun song. Now I know that it's longer than I thought.
Yes.
So Bruce, anything you want to add? Anything, any insights, medical or musical theater wise?
Well, you know, my latest plague is now the pediatric multi-symptom inflammatory disease that is supposed to be happening from COVID. That,
yeah,
you know, that was the source of about 28 phone calls today from my office. But you know, this virus just always has new surprises. There's something every week. You know, a few weeks ago it was just I'm afraid of getting COVID. Then, you know, a week later it was, can I get chloroquine and azithromycin to take, because, you know, it's people are saying that it works, including our president. And now everybody's worried about this inflammatory disease because everybody, you know, with a fever is worried that they have this, you know, sort of that life-threatening issue. And it is, I would just say that if, you know, if your child is running around the house, you know, with 101 fever, they don't have this syndrome, okay? This is a syndrome that people are really, really sick with. One of the criteria is you really have to be hospitalized with it. Like you're that sick that you need to be hospitalized. And it is this kind of Kawasaki disease type of thing where, you know, your blood vessels all get inflamed and you get, you know, red lips, red tongue, swollen hands, swollen feet, very high fever. But, you know, you're really, really sick with this. You know, if you're sitting watching TV just saying, you know, oh, I got the chills, I don't feel great, I'm quite sure you don't have this syndrome. So, and it's a lot rarer than people really think. It's really, I think to date, 2 children in New York City have died from this syndrome, which is too many, but they're think about the thousands and thousands of kids who probably are positive for COVID that we don't even know about. So I would say just watch carefully if you get fever and just do the right things, rest, drink fluids. But, you know, unless you have high fever that goes on more than 5 or 6 days and you're really ill, you can't get up, you can't walk, you can't get out of bed, you know, you're just so sick that you can't even get up. That's something you should definitely call your doctor immediately about. Okay. But I have a feeling it's a little overblown right now, you know, because everybody panics about it.
No, that's good. Good information. Yeah. Good information. Thank you. And just stay, you know, try to keep your stress levels down. Get outside now that the weather is getting nice. You know, get some fresh air. Take a walk. You know, enjoy the outdoors. It's a really good way to keep yourself grounded emotionally.
Play with the dog.
Play with the dog. Yes, absolutely. The dogs are good. Dogs are good. Yes. Well, and donate, please. You know, like I said, any amount, it's very much appreciated.
Yes.
Yes.
I just want to thank Scott and Kayla. Thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for having us.
You guys were fantastic.
Yes.
Really, you sound great, as always.
Yes.
Yes, thank
you. Joelle, thanks for coming on and sharing what you're doing. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course. And then, so our next show on Sunday, we're planning to still perform, postponed from last Sunday.
Yes.
So hopefully that'll work out this time.
How much more talent do we have in Lewisboro? How much longer is this going on here?
I don't know. We're trying to keep it going.
Yeah.
Are we going to recycle? Going to go on to like the second round soon for, you know,
possibly
get Heather back? And
you may have to.
Yes.
All right.
Thinking about that.
Yes. But thanks again. Thanks for everyone tuning in. And we'll hopefully see you Sunday.
Yes. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks, guys.
Bye. Thank you.